You have spoken about man, but what should woman do? What should woman maintain in their eyes?
For a woman, regardless of what her husband is like, she has to accept him as her own account. It is not coincidental that one acquires a husband. No matter what your husband is like, your efforts should be put into becoming a devoted wife. If you are not able to do this, then ask for his forgiveness. This should be your aim. You should be focused on how you can progress further in your partnership with your husband. How will you attain a higher level? How you will both attain moksha? So tell your wife, you can fight with me as much as you want, but Dada has told me not to fight. Dada has given me this command, so I am going to sit here and you can say whatever you want to say.
Then she will remain quiet.
She will become silent when you bring up Dada's name. There is no other weapon. Use this weapon freely. A lady once said to me, when I got married, my husband was very dominant. I asked, how is he now? She proceeded, Dada, you know all about women's behavior, so why are you making me say it? When he wants some happiness from me, I tell him to address me as master. In this way, I make him do what I want. What fault is it of mine? Before, he used to make me call him master, and now I make him say it. When a powerful officer came home after a frustrating day at work, his wife said, you are an hour and a half late. Where have you been? Just look at this. A man with lion-like qualities being scolded. A man whom the whole state of Gujarat fears being scolded like a child. Nobody dare cross him, and yet his own wife did not respect him, and not only that, she even reprimanded him. So one day I told her, what if this husband of yours were to leave you alone and go out of town for a fortnight or so? She said she would be scared. Now, what is she scared of? So she tells me, when I hear a noise in the other room, I think that there may be a ghost there. I told her, you get scared even if a mouse knocks something over. But if your husband were in the house, you would not feel scared. You keep scolding and nagging at him to the point where he feels like nothing. You reduce this lion of a husband of yours to nothing but a sheep. One man bought a mare for 3,000 rupees. Every day he used to sit on the mare. One day his 24-year-old son rode the mare to the local pond. He teased the horse a little. Is a 3,000 rupee mare supposed to be teased? Rather than being teased or instigated, she must be allowed to walk in her own style and at her own pace. When the son teased her, she pounced, and as she did that, the young man fell to the ground. So, what did he say when he got home? Sell this horse. The horse is bad. He's the one who does not know how to sit on the horse, and he's blaming the horse. The definition of a dominant husband is the one who blames and belittles the horse because he does not know how to sit on her or ride her. Should you not know how to treat your wife? If a husband opposes his wife just once, he loses his dignity. The wife will lose respect for him. If your household is running smoothly, the children are doing well in school, and you have no other bothers, and yet you scold your wife and find faults with her, then your wife will lose respect for you. She will know that you have no substance. You do not know how to deal with the ladies. If you, as a shopkeeper, do not know how to deal with your customers, they will not come to you. Don't people say, hire a good salesman? If the salesman is good, handsome, and clever, then people would be willing to pay more. In the same manner, you should know how to conduct your dealings with your wife. It is because there is a presence of a woman that this world has warmth and joy in it. Otherwise, in your household, you would be worse than a hermit. The cleaning and sweeping would not be done in the morning. There would be no signs of tea or breakfast. It is only upon the instructions of the wife that one takes a timely bath. It is because of her that there is a glow and warmth in the home, and her joy is because of him. Women have a tremendous tolerance for pain and suffering. Even when times are very difficult and there is grave suffering, she will tell her husband, "Don't be afraid, just go to sleep. Why are you making yourself unhappy?" She will pacify him. A woman by nature is spontaneous and natural. When the husband incurs a loss of $500,000 or so, he will worry the whole day long about it. If his business is running at a loss, he will not eat properly. A woman, on the other hand, will tell him to stop worrying unnecessarily. She will tell him to eat properly. She is also a 50% partner in the business. Why does she not worry? It is because she is sahaj, that is spontaneous and natural. When you live with sahaj people, then you will survive. Otherwise, you will not. If, on the other hand, two men were to live together, they would not find any meaningful comfort from being with each other. The woman is sahaj, and it is because of her presence that there is joy in the home. A woman is a goddess of strength. If a man understands this, his life's work is done. The woman is not at fault. The fault lies in man's wrong understanding. Women are goddesses. Do not try to make them any lesser. You should say she is a goddess. You may even call her Devi, that is goddess. In northern India, in many places, they address their women as Devi. Even nowadays, they say Sharda Devi has come or Mani Devi has come. Don't they say this in certain places? If four men were to live together, one of them would cook and the others would do something else. Even if the chores were divided, that household would be useless and no fun to live in. If one man and one woman were to live in a home, that home would be beautiful. Women really know how to make things beautiful.
Don't keep siding with just the woman, Dada.
I am not siding with the women. I am really siding with the men. But women think I'm siding with them. In reality, I'm siding with the men because you men are the head of the family. She is not the owner of the family, you are the owner. In Bombay, people asked me why I side with women as opposed to men. I replied, "Lord Mahavir was born to a woman. Who are you men going to give birth to? You people are making a big issue for no reason."
Still, you are partial towards the woman. That is what we believe.
Yes, people have accused me of that, but at the same time, I raise men up so high that even women start to respect them. I arrange things in such a way. If you look at it, on the surface, it appears that I am siding with the women. But from within, I root for the men. Therefore, there has to be ways to arrange things. Both parties need to be satisfied. I get along very well with women as well as men. I neither side with men nor do I side with women. Both have to be equally responsible. People in the past have made women inferior. Women are helpful. If the woman were not there, how would your household run?